There are a lot of ways to apply color to canvas. One of the oldest and most beautiful is glazing. In this video, I'm going to show you what glazing is, how to do it, and how it can help your painting. First, what is glazing? Glazing is the name of a painting technique for applying nearly transparent layers of paint evenly on top of dry paint. The fact that the paint is nearly transparent is the most important aspect of glazing. Because with glazing, you're not painting new colors. You're merely modifying colors that are already there. This brings us to the why of glazing. Instead of thinking about glazing like you're applying paint, think of it like you're applying touch-ups or slight modifications to the dry paint that is already there. Every time you glaze a new layer on top of your painting, you can think about it like these modifications are adding or deepening the colors. They're increasing that chromatic complexity. And also you can use it for creating color harmony. So for example, let's say you're painting a shadow and it isn't dark enough. Okay, instead of repainting that whole area, you can just glaze another color on top of what is already there to deepen that first color. Not only does this save you a lot of time, but also your painting looks richer. It doesn't look as flat. Remember from the last video, there was another painting technique whose goal was to modify existing colors. That was scumbling. Now, scumbling and glazing, they have the same goal to modify an existing color, but they're done very differently. We're going to look at some of those differences. Okay, so both glazing and scumbling have the goal of modifying an existing color, but glazing uses transparent paint and scumbling uses opaque. Additionally, glazing is an even application of the paint across that whole area, whereas scumbling's purpose is to apply an uneven application, a scumble. And lastly, with glazing, you're not adding any texture at all. It's a very, very thin layer you're adding. But scumbling, one of the purposes, is to add texture. Okay, now we know why we glaze and what it is, let's talk about how we can glaze and how it can improve your paintings. Let's talk about brushes first. You can do glazing with any brush. What you want ideally is a brush that can hold a good amount of paint. The most important thing you need to know about glazing is that you need to glaze with transparent paint. So, some paints are already transparent right out of the tube, like alizarin crimson or dioxazine purple, but other paints are opaque. For the opaque paints, like cadmium red or yellow, you're going to want to add a little bit of linseed oil. That will make those opaque paints transparent and ready to glaze. You're going to want to make sure that the linseed oil you add to the paint is mixed in really well. Add enough until you're confident that the paint is nearly transparent. After you glaze a layer on your paintings, please do wait until the painting is dry before glazing another layer. If you don't wait between applications for the paint to dry and you end up glazing a layer on top of wet paint, that's not glazing. That's actually called alla prima, or wet into wet. That will be the focus of our video next week. Something else to note about glazing. You can always glaze colors darker, but you can't really glaze colors lighter. So if you're going to be glazing multiple colors, do them in order from light to dark. I highly suggest you glaze yellow first, then orange, then green, then red, then blue, and finally purple. Okay, that's it. I'll leave you with two final thoughts. Make the paint more transparent than you think you need, and wait longer for that layer to dry than you think you need to wait. For now, that's it. Subscribe, like, comment, and share for more art tips and tutorials. Happy painting!